look out into the bright star fields and swirling dust clouds of space. We seek answers to the biggest questions. Where did our universe come from? How big is the universe? When did it begin? What is the universe made of? And how did life begin? The universe is unimaginably vast. Look up at the night sky and hold your finger out at arm's length. The tiny piece of sky hidden by just your fingernail contains about 4 million galaxies of stars. There are more stars in space than there are grains of sand on all the beaches of all the Earth. And these unimaginable numbers of stars are unimaginably distant. Even our closest star, the Sun, is so far away that its light takes 8 minutes to reach us. As we look deeper into space, the starlight comes from further and further back in time, until we see almost to the origin of the universe itself. 13.7 billion years ago, this vast, expanding universe. All space, time, all energy and matter was located in a single point, infinitesimally small. And then something happened. Something impossible to show. We call that something the Big Bang. We can still detect traces of energy from soon after the Big Bang, all around. Old TV aerials picked it up between the channels. And astronomers can study the details using innovative instruments from ground-based observatories to satellites and probes in space. This is the heat pattern left over from the Big Bang. The image was taken from space by the WMAP and sheds light on questions about the early universe before even the first stars were formed. We now know that mere minutes after the Big Bang, the first stuff began to form. Tiny, tiny atoms. Huge clouds of these atoms drew together, mainly hydrogen and helium. As they heated up, the first stars started to appear. The searing heat and pressure inside stars cooked up new atoms such as carbon and iron, giving out a huge amount of energy and causing the stars to shine. Some of those early stars exploded in spectacular supernovae, sending out huge quantities of matter into space. This became the stuff of more stars, planets such as our own Earth, and also the life which has evolved on Earth. So everything we see around us is made from dust formed in stars billions of years ago. In you, me, and all living things, the atoms forged by stars have formed cells. There are more cells in your body than there are stars in our galaxy. But many living things are made of only one cell. In fact, most life on Earth is microscopic and has been for over 3.5 billion years. So how did the first single-celled life begin? We don't know for certain. Early Earth was very different from today, with violent volcanic eruptions and an atmosphere poisonous to us. Somehow, these conditions on the early Earth caused chemicals to form early cells. Most cells contain DNA, the instructions needed to make another cell. And all life has its own copy of DNA. The chemicals for life are not rare. They are forged in stars everywhere, across the depths of space. Which means the universe could be as teeming with life as it is teeming with stars. From the iron in our blood to calcium in our teeth, from top to toe, we are all made of stardust.